This is amazing. You see what he was showing them? You're afraid of people, but you're not afraid of the law. What's going to happen? Well, they were patient and they waited. But the other people, of course, they kept doing what they do, which is cheating. When they would sell anything and they want to weigh it out and measure it out. Okay, you want to buy this from me? Okay, it weighs 3 pounds. And you say, it looks like 2. Wait a minute. Now it's 3. So he's weighing his thumb with it. Some butchers might do that, you know. And whenever he wants to buy something, he said, no, you know, he take extra and give you a hard time. Or when he wants to pay, he don't want to give you all the money. They were very, very bakhil. What is bakhil? Stingy. They were so stingy. But always the promise of Allah will come. What Allah promises is going to happen. When he promises good, it's going to come. And when he promises bad, that's going to come too. Well, these people, and a lot of the stories I've been telling you, you know, these people depend on water for their crops, water for their animals, and water to live. Water is a very important part of every human being's life. All of us need water, and they were no different. Now, Allah had given them a lot. They had a lot, and they were in good shape. But, of course, they wanted more and more and more. And their prophet's telling them, it's going to come, it's going to come. And they're like, out of here. And then one day, it came, a big cloud. And they said, see, we're going to get rain. We wanted some more water. Rain's coming, the big cloud is coming, and we're going to be fine. Ha ha. So they were looking, thinking the big rain was going to be tarheeb. But it wasn't. It was the promise of Allah, the tarheeb. And it came. And it came so hard. And amazing thing was, the way that it comes, you're looking up, where's the water? No, it was fire. Can fire come from a cloud?
No.
What about lightning? Can lightning come from a cloud?
Yes.
Lightning makes what? Fire. Big fire. So here now is lightning coming, wham, bam, boom, and which is scary in itself. Big fire and shocking, and then of course you get along with that wind and all the things that come. And again, just as in the past with other peoples, Allah destroyed them all, every one of them, because Allah's promise always comes. In the meantime, the people who believed and were following the Prophet Shoaib, Allah spared them, He saved them, because Allah's promise is true both ways. The promise of tarheeb, the punishment, and it came. Promise of tarheeb, which is the good things that you like, and it came. And this is the story of those people. Now, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, is the last prophet, and he told us exactly the same thing, that people live in between these two things all the time. They're looking for the good that they can have, the promise, the tarheeb, and they're afraid of the promise of the bad, the threat that things will come at them. So what we have to do is realize that when anything comes our way, as believers, as Muslims, as the ones who believe in Allah, these difficulties that we have can be good for us. And then those things which we think are good for us, they could actually be bad for us. Let's look at a verse in the Quran and think about it. The verse is in Surah, it's chapter 89 in the Quran, if you go by the numbers like I do. And it tells us in there that whenever Allah tests one of the human beings, He tests the mankind by giving them good. So see, Allah's calling it ibtila. He's calling a test when He gives you something good. He didn't say it was really good. He just said it's a test. And He gives you something called na'mah. What does na'mah mean? A favor from Allah. And which is barakah from Allah, which you say blessings, things like that. You're looking at it like, yeah, I got this, I got that. Wow, I got all these things. Whoa. He says that his servant is going to say what? Allah loves me. Look how much Allah loves me. He gave me this, He gave me this. I got to get a brand new Game Boy, you know, at home playing, have a good time. Got new Barbie dolls. I got all this stuff going on, you know. And then Allah said in the next verse, but whenever we test Him by taking away things that He likes, like what? oh, man, you know, we don't have all this money anymore. Now I don't have the fancy clothes. Maybe I don't get to go to this school anymore. I lost this or I lost that. Maybe somebody dies in your family. It hurts and you feel like, oh. And then what he said. Allah says that the human being will say, Allah, disgrace me. Allah, dishonor me. Look what Allah did to me. And then Allah says, Kalabaltu. Because he's saying here, this is the emphasis for you to see that Allah is saying big time, no way. That is not true. In fact, and then Allah goes on to tell you, the reason for this is because you don't take care of the people who are poor. You don't feed these orphans. There's little children in the street. They don't have anything. You don't care about them. You just go, I don't care about the yatim. These are the children with no parents. And you don't feed the poor. And when you don't take care of the poor, and you don't take care of the orphans, then be ready, because that's the beginning of a trouble for you. Because Allah likes it when you take care of the poor and the orphans. Anyway, I want to come back to this thing about having this test that comes to you. Some people think that if I have the good in this world, it means Allah loves me. But whenever they don't have something, they say, Allah hates me. And it's not true. You want me to give you the story of what Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said? He used a word called ajib. Do you know this word, ajib? Say ajib.
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 What does it mean? Amazing. Ajib. Amazing. Next time you want to tell your friends amazing, say, Ajib. They say, what does that say? It means amazing. Because Prophet Muhammad, he said, peace be upon him, amazing, Ajib is the condition of a true believer. Because only good is going to happen to him. Only good is going to happen to him. Now, how is that? If you think about this, because we know many of the believers have difficulties, yeah? Sure. But Allah's messenger is saying, no, it's all good for him. It's all going to be good for him. For instance, if anything good comes his way, like it mentioned in the first part of that ayah, then he's happy, then he praises Allah. Alhamdulillah. You get something from you, alhamdulillah. Just say, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. But when the bad things come and the test called ibtila from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, any difficulty, any fitna comes from Allah, then what does he say? Alhamdulillah still, and he's patient. And we talked about that before, about being patient. Because the patience to just be able to say, alhamdulillah, 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 and not get upset, not get angry. And Allah speaks to us through the Quran, and he tells us that the things that we like, sometimes they're not good for us. Sometimes you like a thing, it's not good for you. And sometimes you don't like something, but it was good for you. Would you let me give you an example of this? Suppose you'd like to watch the cable TV, huh? You think it's good for you? But it's not good for you. And if the cable TV quits working, you say, oh, this is bad. But actually, it's good for you. Because there's a lot of things on there that you shouldn't watch. They won't help you. They could hurt you, damage you. So many times human beings think, oh, this is good, but it's not good to Allah. Or they say, this is bad, but it's not bad to Allah. Now, a believer in Allah is ajib, amazing. His condition is amazing. And the Prophet ﷺ said it, because whenever anything good comes his way, he's thankful to Allah. He says, alhamdulillah. But any difficulty comes his way, he's patient with Allah. And these are some of the stories that we've heard from these prophets. How that good things came. And look, they were patient with good and patient with bad. You might say, well, what do you mean patient with good? Because sometimes when good stuff comes to you, you get too excited. You don't have to be like that. Because you don't know exactly what good is in it or what bad is in it. And also, when any difficulty comes, you don't have to think it's all bad. There can be good things that come out of everything. So the patience that we learn, maybe it's just Allah teaching us a lesson, but we're patient. Prophet ﷺ said, and it's good for them. Good for them. But it's only going to be in the case of a believer. Because what? For believers, everything is good. because they believe